I wonder if there's anybody in the city of Detroit recognize this young man. Do you guys recognize this young man?
Yo.
Somebody said Eddie. Welcome, Eddie LeVert and Sammy.
Yeah, thank you. Right.
You guys have a lot of energy. I'll just get right into the interview. First time I saw you perform at Henry's, you shook me up. I don't know if you do this every night or if the spirit just hit you, but you just took off and started running. And right like you was going to the crowd. Is this spontaneous or is it just Eddie LeVert?
I would like to think that it's Eddie LeVert. And it's part of the OJ's thing that we do that, you know. The energy, you know, we're living in a very physical world, so everybody has to give up that oomph to get it back, right?
We call it a little geek. Sammy. I hear that. How does it feel being part of a living legend? Everywhere you go, the crowds are big. The girls are screaming, the money is good, the food is good, the wine is good.
Yeah. Well, I'm so used to it now. It'll be 9 years next
really?
Year. Yeah. People don't realize that every time they see me, they say, it's the new guy, but 9 years, you're not new.
Is he new after 9 years? No, not after nine.
No. So I feel as though I've sang with the guys all my life.
What part of Ohio are you guys from?
Cleveland.
Cleveland, right out of Cleveland.
Mm-hmm.
Any particular section of Cleveland?
Well, me and Walt stays. We stay in Shaker Heights.
You still stay there right now in Cleveland?
Yeah,
that's your home?
Yeah.
Our neighboring state. We know we run in and out of Cleveland all the time.
Yeah, well, we're going to beat y'all up, too, on football, too.
Hey, the way the Lions have been playing. As a matter of fact, you guys did beat us.
Yeah, that's right. We've been beating y'all for the last couple of years.
You're going to do the Henry's Lounge, and I guess the last time you did it was a history-making event, whether you knew it or not. You came into the city, and Henry's Lounge was a brand-new remodeled place. Mm-hmm. It had gotten bigger, expanded. Mm-hmm. And you guys really packed it, and I don't think it's been packed since then, not the way it was. Well, got to pack it again.
Oh! Yeah, If we can get all of them to come down there, it'd be all right. It'd be live. We like that because we get a chance to come back and play for the real people. You know what I'm saying? Like when we play places like Cobo Hall and Joe Louis Arena, like the intimacy is not there anymore. So when you play places like Henry's Palace, you get a chance to go back to your roots and to the people that have been supporting you all the years.
Does that intimacy help you to perform better?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
you can feel
absolutely.
People.
Yeah,
there's a magic that occurs between the performer and the audience, and when you have that one-on-one, it's like singing one-on-one. You know, you can actually touch and look and feel.
You have that real spiritual feeling and flavor to the music also.
Well, was brought up in the gospel, was brought up sung in church every Sunday, mm-hmm. twice on Sunday, had to go to church every Sunday mm-hmm. or else, you know, couldn't stay in that house, you know. My mom, my father, mm-hmm. all of them mm-hmm. was very church-related people. Also, Walter's father used to direct a choir, so we all used to sing in the choir.
You mentioned Walter.
Yeah. Well, he missed his plane coming out of Boston, man. Yeah, he might have floated into Cape Cod.
He should be here. Don't panic. He'll be here tonight and tomorrow night and Sunday night.
What would happen? Could you guys perform without him? I mean, as good as you are?
No way. Don't you even try. What a guy, y'all. Give him a nice round of applause.
You wouldn't do that. What a guy.
Well, I had talked with Sammy earlier. He says he should be checking in to the hotel right about
now. He should be in now. Yeah.
The OJs, where to from here? You guys with the guys behind you, I'm almost about because we've got Eddie Holland sitting in the back, but mm-hmm. he comes from
the same era.
Same era, same type of guys as the guys who have produced you guys so many years.
Kenny and Leon? Right. Yeah, okay. Kenny Gamble, Leon Huff.
Right.
The question again, let me hear what was the question again?
Where to from now?
Well, to the top of the world, top of the charts. top in the people's heart, whatever. You know, we're still very much into it. We're still very much into the music that's happening now. We still want to be sexy, sexy. We still want to do all of it.
Okay. We've got a videotape, if you don't mind, if we would roll one of your older songs as we lead to commercial break.
Okay.
One of the older songs. But all of your songs are great songs.
Okay.
Would you attribute that to your performance or to the writer or to the combination of that?
I would say the whole spectrum, the everybody, the whole thing, the writers, the music, and all of that.
I think that is,
yeah,
production.
Right, all that works.
If we could get a roll on the OJs live on videotape, we're going to roll the OJs in a performance right now.